Thank you so much. Guten Tag, ladies and gentlemen, meine Damen und Herren. Ich spreche nicht Deutsch. Sie erlauben mir, in Englisch vorzufahren. I will be very happy to tell you then how happy I am and honored to be here in your fabulous city and in this, what is called deservingly, a temple of art, and to stand before your very great orchestra, whose invitation to me is certainly one of the greatest honors of my life. Any musician. Any musician accorded the privilege of standing in front of this group of musicians is one greatly honored, and I treasure this moment. Also joining us today is Anna-Sophie Mutter, who you all know. You certainly know that Anna-Sophie Mutter is many things. She is one of the world's greatest violinists. She is a wonderful mother. She brings honor to her country. And in going to Australia and to Asia, South America, North America, Europe, she's indeed a very great world citizen. And it's again an honor, also in the privilege, to welcome to the stage Anna-Sophie Mutter.
Thank you. Thank you.
So thank you very much. What is coming now is the end of E.T., the extraterrestrial. Many of you will remember the film. It was directed by Steven Spielberg, and he and I have been working together for, I think, 44 years, something like that. And it has been like a very good marriage. We haven't had any arguments. We don't have to talk to each other every day. And so far it's working very, very well, I hope. At this end of E.T., you'll hear the music. It begins very quickly in an agitated way when the little Earth children are on their bicycles. They're trying to get E.T. back to the spaceship so he can go back to his home. And they are pursued by the police, and they go quickly on their bicycles over faster, 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 achieving what we can imagine is escape gravity velocity. Maybe a physicist here will tell, 35 miles an hour, something like that, escape. And they escape the gravity speed and fly over the moon. And we accept it perfectly. It seems very natural. And they land very gracefully on the ground. You remember him set E.T. down. And then there's some sentimental music coming at the end, which accompanied the dialogue between E.T. and his little Earthling friends as E.T. departs. And then at the end of the music, there's a fanfare and flourishes from the orchestra that completes the film. What I love about these kind of concerts is that you can hear the orchestra and you can hear the contribution that the orchestra, all of our orchestras make to these films. We go to the theater and we don't notice the virtuosity that's being put into the soundtrack. And now we have one of the greatest orchestras in the world doing it for us. And you can imagine a composer's delicate vanity, being able and satisfied by having the orchestra play it without the distraction of the film. all the no notes aren't covered up by spaceships or horses' hooves or dialogue or whatever, the enemies of music. I shouldn't put it that way, but this is the end of the orchestra's contribution to the end of the film, E.T.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. A word or two about Star Wars. All nine of them. When we first began this project in 1977, the writer, director, producer, George Lucas, who you're probably familiar with, gave us no indication at the time that there was to be a second film. And so I watched the film, and I saw Luke and Leia, and I saw they were two attractive young people, and they were doing their comedy scenes and their action scenes. So I made the assumption that at the end of the film and in their future, they looked to me like they might become lovers and have parents, be parents and have a life together. And 2 years later, in the second film, George Lucas said to me, no, they're not lovers, they're brother and sister. So I was off by a little bit. But nevertheless, we played the love theme. This is one of the themes from the second film, The Empire Strikes Back, that will be included in this little triptych that we'll do. And then finally, the march from the very first episode. We've just completed the ninth one. I think it's in the theaters here now. So we've put a bow on it, which I think, at least from my own personal point of view and contribution, that will be a nice, tidy number, nine. And so here are three little pieces from Star Wars. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. This little piece is from a film, Cinderella Liberty, by Mark Rydell some years ago, played by Marcia Mason, who's a fantastic actress. And it was a story of a girl, a very simple, straight line in her life, and she made a few wrong choices, another few wrong choices, and her life became unraveled. It was very sadly sweet and very beautiful also. This is the theme from Cinderella Liberty.
Thank you. this little piece is from Tintin, and it's a sword fight. I don't know how you say it in English. Sword fight. And in a cartoon, and they tease the feathers with the tip of their swords, never cutting, and you will hear these little feather twists in this little piece, the duel.
Thank you. Thank you.